All right, so for tonight, we are going to define what is a financial statement or your financial statements, okay? We are going to identify the importance of your financial statements as well later on. And of course, our core topic for tonight, ano ba yung types or what are the types of your financial statements and what are the different information that they are conveying to us, okay? Or what are the information that are communicated using these financial statements. And of course, identify how and where financial statements are made and learn to read financial statements. So basically, no, kung magdi-dig deeper ka dito sa part na to, learn how to read your FS, you are actually going into your pwedeng MS na or FinMan kasi kung pupunta ka dun sa part na yon, doon papasok or doon may inject yung FS analysis, okay? But anyway, dito sa basic accounting natin, I'll just be teaching you the basic muna. Syempre, ano ba yung nandito sa loob ng FS mo or ano ba yung makikita mo doon? Syempre, ano yung naka-present sa'yo sa FS? How will you read that? And of course, meron akong 10 important things na nilista para sa iyo that you need to know about your financial statements. Now, number one ulit na i-take note mo, sabi ko nga sa inyo kanina, your FS. This FS, or itong FS na to na pinakita ko sa inyo, no? These are summarized. Meaning, on the face of your FS, you'll not be able to see the detail. So, saan mo makikita yung detail? Let's say the cash. Uy, saan galing kaya itong 1,225,000 na cash on hand niya or itong cash na nakareflect sa FS niya. May kita mo na lang yan sa notes. So, the notes on your FS, yan actually yung panglima natin ngayon, no? The notes on your FS is the disaggregation. So, spell ba natin? Anyway, ito, disaggregation. So, pag sinabing natin disaggregation, okay, tama ba ako? Yung disaggregation mo, yan na yung paano mo na derive or that is already the detail of the total account reflected on your FS. Let's see sa expense mo. Ang expense mo, number one dyan, una mong expense actually dyan, di ba? Yung cost of goods sold. Of the total cost of goods sold, paano mo ba nakuha yun? Makikita mo yun sa notes mo ngayon. So, sa FS mo, meron kang mga, may column ka doon na nakasulat, let's say, note number one, note number two. So, anong role nun para makita ni user mo saan nang galing or paano mo na-compute yung cost of goods sold mo? Or let's say, paano mo nalaman na ito yung cash mo kasama na yung cash and cash equivalent mo aside from the ending cash balance on your cash flow? Then, makikita yan sa notes to FS. And of course, aside from the disaggregations, the different disclosures or explanations na kailangan malaman ng users natin. But of course, not all, okay? Hindi naman lahat sasabihin mo or ilalagay mo sa notes. Of course, those items only that will affect the decision making of your users, which are also reflected on your FS. So, yun lang yung kasali sa FS notes natin. Okay. Now, sino bang gumagawa ng FS? Okay? Ikaw, in the future, gagawin mo rin to. Naniniwala ka ba? Nagagawa ka rin ng FS sa future? Yes. Dapat yes. Positive. Okay? Number one, patok na patok to, patok na patok talaga. Uso na to ngayon, you have your software or your accounting software. And of course, balikan mo pa rin yung historical and of course, meron ka pa rin ito ngayon, your bookkeepers and lastly, ikaw to in the future, accountant. Okay? Magpe-prepare ka in the future. Ito mga to yung nagpe-prepare. Number one, si bookkeeper, hindi mawawala yan. Why? Actually, the bookkeeper is the one doing the journal. So, siya yung nagre-reflect actually sa libro mo nung mga nagiging transaction mo for the year. So, siya yung nag-journalize. Okay? You also have like, for example, in a company, meron kang accounting officer. Okay? Si accounting officer naman, pwedeng yun yung position niya. Let's say that's a designated position. Okay? Sila naman yung gagawa na ngayon ng next steps mo. So, you already have your books, you have your journal, you have your ledger. Next step na dyan, di ba, sila trial balance na pag-usapan natin sa ating accounting cycle, the trial balance, and then the trial balance is already the tool for you to create your FS already, okay? But subject to adjustment pa bago mo makuha yung FS mo. Syempre, dapat adjusted yung nasa FS mo, okay? So, si bookkeeper, isa siya sa key person na gumagawa talaga ng FS mo kasi siya number one yung original na magre-record yan sa libro, tutulong siya sa trial balance, okay? And of course, the accountant. So, si accountant siya ang magpa-finalize ng buong FS ni company. Statement of financial position, income statement, cash flow, equity changes, and of course, your notes. So, kapag kailangan ni management, kailangan ni bossing, kailangan ni directors, board of directors, kailangan ng shareholders, okay? So, si accountant. Tatanungin natin si accountant dyan. And of course, together with your bookkeeper and your accountant, today, you already have your accounting softwares already, di ba? So now, etong trial balance mo, assuming, di ba, if you have already your application or your software, pwedeng maka-generate ka ng trial balance, i-counter-check mo na lang siya. So ang gagawin mo na lang, you are going to look at your future adjustments for your adjusting journal entry. And tutulungan ka ni software, actually meron na nga ngayon yung mga software na diretso ipapresent na niya sa inyo yung FS, o di ba? So, but don't worry, hindi ka pa rin mapapalitan as an accountant because, as I've said or as I've mentioned before, kailangan pa rin natin ang professional judgment mo, okay? So, hindi makukuha ni computer yung professional judgment mo. But anyway, going back, yun nga, meron na kasi tayong mga applications ngayon, no, na diretso, di ba? Kailangan mo na lang i-enter yung transaction. Siyempre, dapat si application alam na lang niya kung saan to diretso next. Okay? Well, that's part of the IT work naman na. Alright? So, yan yung mga items or kung paano or ways kung paano natin nagagawang FS natin. Number one, basically, don't forget your bookkeeper. And of course, the accountant with the help. Okay? So, mas maganda kasing pakinggan yun, di ba? With the help of your accounting software. Kesa naman yung ginawa ni accounting software. Eh, saan ba galing yung ginawa ni software? Di ba galing din sa in-enter ng bookkeeper natin? Okay. Alright. Next one is, of course, the items or the things that you need to know when you talk about your FS. Siyempre, dapat kailangan mo itong malaman. Okay? So, meron lang akong 10 na in-outline dito that is about your FS. Ito yung mga dapat mong tandaan or hindi mo dapat nakakalimutan as you go on with your accounting journey or as you go back to accounting na binabalikan mo siya ngayon. Number one, meron kang 4 basic financial statements na pag-usapan natin. Statement of financial position, it is stating to you or it communicates to you the position of the company. Okay? Nasaan ba ang company mo ba ngayon? I-compare mo yan sa ibang company. Maganda ba? Okay. I-compare mo yung asset nila or i-compare mo yung liability ratio nila sa ratio ng liability ni other related company. Diyan mo makikita ngayon. Next, of course, your income statement. Dito mo ngayon makikita ang performance ng company mo. Kumita ba tayo? Nalugi ba tayo? Okay. Anong nagdala sa company natin? Baka naman ang nagdala lang sa atin is other gains. O, di ba? Malungkot naman kapag ganun, dapat magdadala pa rin sa'yo is of course yung revenue mo from normal operation. Okay, so dyan mo makikita yan, income statement. And of course, the other two, your cash flow. Again, yung cash flow mo, that's divided into 3. You have your operating, investing, and financing. So dito mo makikita saan ba napupunta, saan nanggagaling, saan nagagamit yung cash ng company mo. Okay? So, of course, in cash flow, cash basis ang gagamitin mo dito. So, lahat ng mga naka-accrual, okay, parang win-work back mo yan when you talk about the cash flow statement. And lastly, the changes in your statement and the changes of your equity. So, movement naman yan ng retained earnings specifically and of course, any dagdag or bawas sa ating capital stock. Okay? Next, of course, last dyan, kasi yung panglima nga natin, yung notes. That's already the disaggregation and the disclosures. Number 2 na dapat mong tandaan, each financial statement tells a different story about a business. So, nakita mo naman kanina yun, pinakita ko. Ano, or sinabi ko actually, sorry. Ano yung pinapakita ni financial position? Okay? Ano ba yung pinapakita ni income statement? Diba iba-iba sila? They have their own essence. They have their own idea to tell to a certain user, okay? But also remember that they are interrelated, okay? So, if you wanted to dig deeper into the company at gusto mong i-analyze pa sila, it's better if you analyze it together. Huwag mo lang silang i-analyze as one na, oops, statement of financial position, maganda ba? Hindi. Kapag ayaw mo yung position niya sa company, oops, I will not invest. Okay? Yung mga ganyang tipo ba ng mga decision. Okay? So, dapat tignan mo. Because it will give you better decisions as a user. Next one, your financial reporting reflects real life event. Of course, hindi naman yan. Iniimbento lang ng bookkeeper mo. Why? Because if you are audited by the external auditors, yung pinapakita mo sa FS mo, you have to support that. Number one, with your source document. Number two, with your books. Okay? And of course, kung ano ba yung software na ginagamit mo, di ba? Next one, number four, it is full of jargon, di ba? Dito ka talaga malilito, di ba? Punta ka pa lang sa FS analysis mo mamaya eh. Baka pag ni-review mo to, nahihilo ka na. And ang dami talaga, okay? So, yan yung mga items na dapat mong malaman. Number one, nung nasa basic accounting ka, chart of accounts pa nga lang, di ba? Nalilito ka na. So, dapat hasain mo ulit yan, no? Yan yung mga dapat mong malaman or mga dapat mong balikan and dapat mong tatandaan lagi. It's full of jargon and dapat yung terms na yon alam mo na yung pinagkaiba like accounts payable, accounts receivable. Kung hanggang ngayon, nalilito ka pa rin, you read, okay? I-review mo lang sila. I know. May di-differentiate mo rin sila eventually. And malalaman mo, may isa sa puso mo, ano ba itong mga iba't ibang jargons na to. Next one, your financial reporting is guided by GAAP. Yung FS mo, hindi mo yan ginawa according to the decision of the accountant. No, okay? Hindi niya sinabi na, oops, ang PPE gusto ko all at fair value. Yun pala, naka-revaluation sila, okay? I mean, all at historical cost, yun pala, naka-revaluation method sila. So, your FS are guided by GAAP, meaning it's according to your standards, according to the accepted principle on how you account the different items on your FS. Starting from your asset until your equity, until the different items of your revenue and expense. So, lahat yan, lahat ng recognitions mo dyan, guided by your accounting principles. Next one, for number six, it lacks important context. Yun nga lang ang kulang kay ano natin, no, kay FS. Kasi sabi natin, it's a summarized information eh. So, kung gusto mo ng detailed, I think it's better if you have your management or tailored reports from the management. Okay? So, yun naman yung kagandahan kapag gusto mo ng detailed reports. Okay, yung tipong meron kang different segments in the company, you wanted to know, is it because of segment A or is it because of segment B, yung mga ganyang information. It's better if you have or if you use management or tailored report. Okay, next one, for parent companies, consolidated financial statements are also important. Of course, this is very important, kaya pag nagpunta ka sa AFAR, isa to sa mga mahahabang topic nyo, tama ba? Yes, because it's very important. And kung kailan mo i-consider na dapat meron kang consolidated FS or when is it not already necessary. Next one, your footnotes are also important. So, yung footnotes mo as well as your other disclosures na nakalagay sa notes. So, si footnote mo, yung footnote mo, it's talking about the notes sa konting notes lang naman yun sa face ng FS mo mismo, aside from the disclosures na makikita mo sa ating notes to FS. Next is that your financial analyst translates figures into ratios and indicators. Okay? You need to know this because, as I said earlier, if you wanted to dig deeper in a company and if you wanted to read or if you wanted to do better understanding or decision making, you're going to use ratio. Mas magandang maintindihan mo yung position ni company, yung return mo, yung profitability mo, when you connect your income statement with your financial position. Yun yung idea nitong number 9 mo, okay? So, yung financial analyst mo, ginagawa niya yung mga ratios para ma-compare and ma-contrast, okay? Let's say, from year 1 until year 3, ano ba yung naging trend natin? From year 1 until year 3, titingnan mo gumanda ba yung performance natin and yung performance natin, hindi mo naman yan ibe-base lang sa bottom line mo na income statement. You can also base it using the ratios. Okay? Aside from that, pwede mong kunin yung or pwede mong tingnan yung FS ng other company. Compare mo sa company na hawak-hawak mo ngayon with the same industry, maybe yun yung gusto mong gawin, pwede mo makita yan na, oops, company B is doing better than my company. Pwede mong magawa yun, okay? With the help of your ratio. And lastly, your financial reporting can help you with your corporate strategy, of course. Okay? Number one yan, na importance and items na dapat mong malaman kung bakit ka may FS. Your FS are actually helping you to do better in your performance or in your company as a whole. Siyempre, sino naman ang gustong may lower performance or lower position in the industry? Of course, using your FS, pwede mong malaman saan ako pwedeng bumawi or saan ba ako may mga drawbacks na side or saan ba ako may mga bottlenecks, di ba? Makikita mo yan sa FS more. Your FS will help you so that you dig deeper into the operation of your company. Baka naman nakasegment ka, so si one segment mo, it affected the entire company, then you can improve the performance of that segment. Di ba? So, pwede rin na baka inisip mo na, oops, let's drop this segment. So, instead of dropping, maybe you could improve the performance of that segment together with the other segment. Okay? So, what else? Let's say you have different divisions. So, the performance of one division or one department of your company affected. Okay? And meron din namang divisions na hindi naman affected. You can also dig deeper into that. But of course, that's under management side already. So, kung gusto mo na ng detail. But of course, saan mo galing yung idea na yun kung bakit ka magdi-dig deeper or why will you look into the inside of the company? It's because of your FS, yung mga items na na-relay sa'yo or na-communicate sa'yo nung FS natin. Okay? So, that is the basics of your FS. Again, your FS are the means for you to communicate the performance of your business or the position of your business. Okay? Alright. All right. So, okay na ba tayo, everyone? We've been able to do or to accomplish our beginner's guide to your FS. Now, if you wanted to have a deeper analysis ng FS mo, you better enroll, okay? Or if you are doing it on your own, I advise you to go to your FS analysis part, okay? So, si FS analysis mo, nandun yung mga deeper items natin in terms of your financial statements, like in terms of reading your FS, I should say, okay? In terms of reading and interpreting your FS. Okay? So, thank you for tonight. Thank you for being with me tonight. So, see you again on our next session. Perhaps, more basic accounting review or guide. So, kung may mga question kayo, send nyo lang sa amin or sa atin, di ba? Or may mga suggestions kayo, we are very much open. And of course, para may access ka na din sa iba, you better enroll now on our basic accounting review session. So, meron ka ng access doon. Sabi ni Sir Tristan kanina, di ba? Lifetime access mo na yan. So, you can already go back to those topics again and again kung kailan mo gusto if you enrolled here. Okay? So, again, thank you and see you on our future sessions pa. More sessions together pa. Okay? Thank you and goodbye. Good night. God bless on your review.